Joe hung out with some of his problems, talked to him man to man a few times. It's about some problems that we were having. I talked to him, he'd talk to me. We always worked things out. They started seeing Cassie, and Cassie started coming around. And I didn't know what to think of her at first, but I started warming up to her.
We're not mad.
Started coming around a little bit more and more. Started getting used to her a little bit more. Me and Tyler would talk about things. Those are for a later day.
Not to me.
But on a serious note, I don't think I've ever seen a couple that's more suited for each other than you two. You two are great together. Y'all have this special chemistry that goes with one another.
Chemistry.
I don't think y'all are going to have any problems. Anything that y'all come across, y'all be able to work it out in life. Y'all just got that special bond. This is y'all's day. Just hope it's been special for y'all. I just want to say congratulations again. The best for y'all in life. I'm always here for y'all when the time is to me. Congratulations.
It's always been about me, myself, and I. If our relationships were nothing but a waste of time, I never wanted to be anybody's other half. I was happy saying I'd love that wouldn't last. That was the only way I knew till I met you. You make me wanna say I do, I do, I do, 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 do. Yeah, I do. Do, do, do. Cause every time before it's been like maybe yes and maybe no. I can live without it, I can let it go. Ooh, what did I get myself into? You make me wanna say I do, I do.
I'm breathing my last breath. Feeling like I'm walking my last steps. Look at all of these tears I've wept. Look at all the promises that I've kept. I put my into your hands. Here's my soul to keep. I let you in with all that I can. You're not hard to reach, and you've blessed me with the best gift that I've ever known. You give me purpose. Yeah, you've given me thinking my journey's come to an end. Oh, send me. learning how to farewell to my friends.
Who gives this ride away?
Her mother and I.
I think it's safe to say that neither of us planned on finding our soulmate at 17 years old, but somehow we, of all people, managed to do it. After months of trying to copy your chemistry homework and acting like I didn't know what to do in statistics, it finally paid off and you got the hint. I knew I made the right choice when we went on our first date because I finally found someone with worse luck than me. Somehow, we managed to find the one theater without heat in January. Even though the circumstances were bad, we still had fun and we enjoyed ourselves. Months went by and I knew I liked you, but I will never forget the time I realized how much I loved you. At 17, I never thought about forever, but when we sat in that hot parking lot for 2 hours waiting to go eat, I had felt something I never felt before. And when you got out of your old broken down Jeep, I looked at you and I realized, wow, I could finally spend the rest of my life with this guy. And at first, I'm not gonna lie, it really, really freaked me out. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized I had no clue what I would do without you in my life. Over the last 4 years, you have taught me so much. Your dedication to every aspect of life has made me learn perseverance. Your optimistic outlook on everything in life has made me learn to see the good in things. Your kindness to everyone has made me strive to be a better person. And because of you, my world is truly better in every way. And I realized life was no longer just about me, but it was about us. And at that moment, I knew you were the one I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. In sickness and in health, I promised to take care of you, even though you were the most dramatic person on this entire earth. For richer or poorer, I promised to always try and save our money, but I can't promise I'll be good at it. For better or for worse, I promise to celebrate your successes and love you more for your failures, till death do us part. Marriage isn't just about living life together and going through the motions. It's not about the white picket fence or the green grass or what sits in our driveway or even how much is in our bank account. But it's about experiencing life together and loving each other through it all, no matter what comes our way. I'd say we've done that and more, and I have no doubt that we will continue to do so.
When I think of you, I can't help but go back in time and think of where it all began. I distinctly remember you being in my chemistry and math classes, constantly asking me for help. I didn't mind, because I enjoyed to help people out. Little did I know there was a deeper meaning. Every other day, you'd be asking for my help, and even one time, you brought me food from Taco Bell as a thank you. So at this point, I knew I couldn't resist this girl right here. I remember the time you wrote me into texting you because we were tweeting each other, and your Twitter randomly stopped working. But me being the naive guy that I am, just went with it, without no questions asked. And how could I forget our improv dance at our senior prom, where everyone stepped aside to witness our dancing skills, as if I had any. The countless dinner dates at China One, the countless late night drives we would take while you played your collection of 100,000 CDs, and the countless movies we went and watched, even when you took my jacket in the negative 100 degree theater room. And so many wonderful things that we have shared together made me realize that God blessed me with such a beautiful person inside and out. As I continue to grow in life with you by my side, I can't think of anything but joy and purpose. You have brought me out to the person I truly am. Believe it or not, I didn't used to be this outgoing until I met her. You love me so unconditionally that everyone around us envies that passion that you possess. You love me so much that it pains you to see others' wrongdoings towards me. And you would do anything in this world for me without any regret. You have such a loving heart towards everything, and it even makes me smile when you get sad because a piece of paper might feel lonely. You're so intelligent, you are like the 4.0 GPA queen, and I'm literally so proud of you for the wisdom that you have. I promise to never leave you, I promise to take care of you, to provide for you, to hold your hand in mine as we continue our life's journey. I promise to be faithful and patient, I promise that I will do everything in my power to keep you happy. I promise to appreciate you and to make sure you know that you are loved every single day. I promise that you will always feel beautiful, and I promise that you will never be lonely. I will always be here for you through everything, and I can't wait to spend the rest of our lives together. You are my rock, my life, my love. And I will always be forever grateful and thank the good Lord above for allowing me to have such an amazing person to call my wife.
As with any new endeavor, it is best to start with clean slate, putting problems big and small behind you. You come acknowledging that your spouse is not perfect. Whatever difficulties you may have experienced, today you have decided that your love is bigger than any of them, and you have chosen to show your commitment to each other. As you wash your hands in this bowl of water, forgive yourself and each other for any pain in the past. Allow yourself to be forgiven for your human imperfections. Allowing yourself to have your hands dried by each other signifies your humbleness, and we have to be humble. It breaks through isolation in our own humbleness. Tyler and Cassidy, do you begin this new chapter of your lives together with grace and compassion?
We do.
We do.
For as much as Tyler and Cassidy have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, then they too have pledged their faith each to the other by giving and receiving of rings and by joining hands. By the powers vested in me by God in the state of West Virginia, I now pronounce you husband and wife together in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You may kiss the bride. I now present to you Tyler and Cassidy D'Angelo.
All the newness in college and everything. And I told her, I said, if you guys can make it through college, then you can make it through anything. And here we are, making it through. I've never seen a couple fight more or love harder or grow more as a couple as these two. And I really feel like if anybody's gonna make it, it's you guys. So that's it.
Let me kiss you all night, feel the afterglow. So what I She is my trophy, this is my only chance, and diving all the way up.